All right, this is Team GN Tech Industry, and I'm the leader, An So Myung, aka Sean. And let me introduce our team real quick. Me as a leader, my role in this team is mapper and designer. And Kim Eun-ji, her role in this team is accountant and journalist. And Lee Jin Myung, his role in this team is communicator and scheduler. All right, so let's go to the second page. Problem definition. So our problem was manual labor, a lot of manual labors in this shrimp cultivating pond. And in manual labor, what they do is they manually check all the sensors, and if the dissolved oxygen in the water is below or not, is below the standard or not, they check it by hands. And by doing so, there are a lot of human errors, and usually because of the human errors, the aerator, which makes the bubbles and which makes the pond full of oxygen, it gets overloaded, and the electricity bills, they skyrocket. So that was the problem, and we came up with our concept. So our concept design is full automation. So our main keyword is no-touch automation, and simpler apparatus, less maintenance. And lastly, simpler codes, more user-friendly. So so far, all this, like from the educational apparatus to business apparatus, a lot of these devices are very hard to maintain because their codes are very hard to manipulate, and usually because it's money related, it's like the company's secret. So with the security issue, it is hard to actually get what you want from this data. So we came up with this very simple design with the simple functions. So let's go to the page 4 detailed design. This is the circuit that we came up with. From the left, you can see that the 12 DC motor, and we actually used a 12 volt BRDC motor because our motor doesn't need to be go reverse, because it only needs to make the oxygen inside the water. And then we used L298N drive module for the Arduino. And then we used three batteries, three lithium ion batteries, 186050. And then we used Arduino Uno, and we used a 20x4 LCD screen. And then we also used this DF robot, DO sensor. Yep. And let's go to page 5, making product. So we wanted to actually make it as big as we could, but that takes a lot of money. And then we just wanted to show, we just wanted to share our concept, our pure concept. So we came up with this rig design, like an oil rig on the ocean. That's why we call it rig. And you can see that there's a cap. It's to protect the water. I know it's to protect the circuits from the water. And then in the cap, there are gonna be batteries, DO chip, Arduino, and L298, and a lot of circuits. And also, there's gonna be an LCD screen on the top of the cap. And this finally on the right, this rig is going to sustain all the circuits. And then there's a aerator under the rig, making the bubbles with the oxygen full of it. And let's go to page 6, product user manual. So from now on, we're going to show you the video about how we could use it. All right, thanks for listening. Okay, so what you're seeing now is the footage of the calibration of the DO probe. And when it's calibrated, the DO probe gets wet by the NaOH, 0.5 mole per liter. And when the voltage meter gets stable, like right now with the 2070, we're gonna use it as a standard. So the standard was 2065 or 2070. So we take out this 1600, and instead we put 2065. And that is the standard, and now we can actually use this DO probe. So we're gonna unload it. All right, it's done. So you can check out that the DO probe is outside of water. That is why it's over 6 milligram per liter. And we actually set the DO data standard as 5 milligram per liter. So when the DO data that DO probe is catching below 5 milligram per liter, this device, this automatic aerator, runs. And when it reaches over 5 milligram per liter, this motor stops. That is why it says motor status off. And you can also check the current temperature and how many seconds it has been running. Now we actually put the device inside the water tank. And since the water, we just got it from the running water, and there's not much of an oxygen inside. And when we give it a couple minutes, it's gonna run. And right now, the probe has its bubbles from the outside. Like when it was outside the tank, there was an air. Some of air got inside the probe, and it's still catching the oxygen from the air. That is why it says, oh, 6 milligram per liter. And now it just changed to 5 because it just caught the water oxygen level. And You can see that motor speed is 260, 4, 5, and now it's off again because it has been running. And this aerator is actually doing the job, making oxygen, you know, dissolving inside the water. So this was GM Tech Industry, and thank you.